Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
God bless you all for making it tonight. Amen. Take it back a bit, Joes. God bless you. Now, I want you all to please open your Bibles with me. Everyone on Apostolic TV, welcome to our midweek power service. This is where we teach the word. This is a word house. Hallelujah.
Praise
God. Bless you all. Apostolic TV, Facebook, God bless you. Everyone here physically, God bless you for making it this week. Amen. Midweek service. Now, hear me. There is something the Lord said I should share before we go into the message tonight. He said, every ministry where there is the evidence of his power, he said we must really spend time on his word. The reason why he said that is that if you go to the book of Revelations, the angel of the church to the church of Ephesus, the letter written to the church of Ephesus, the church of Ephesus was known for power, but yet they messed up. It is the word of God. You know, I preached a message titled what? Some time ago, a message titled Something More Than the Anointing and Power. Mm. The disciples came to Jesus in the book of Matthew and the book of Luke, and they said, Master, demons were subjected to us. And Jesus said, don't be excited because demons are subjected to you. He said, instead, rejoice when a name is written in the book of life. Meaning there is something more important than the anointing and power. Please, I love the power of God in this ministry because it's only going to grow.
Amen.
It's only going to be greater.
Amen.
But I want us to match it equally with the word of God. Let's have a balanced diet in the spirit. Before Jesus went about doing good, he needed the anointing of the Holy Ghost first and then power. Amen. The Holy Ghost is the very person of, is the very spirit of the living God. Amen. So please, as we are praying for the anointing for power, let's cry for his anointing, the anointing of the spirit, and then carry the word of God. Amen. Please grab your notepads where you are. Grab your Bibles. Grab your Bibles. Grab your notepads. But most importantly, make sure you have your faith pad ready, because your faith is that pad that launches you into the realms of all what? Possibilities. Break your Bibles with me to Jeremiah chapter 33. I have to move swiftly because I have another ministration by 10:30 tonight. So I have to move swiftly. Jeremiah chapter 33, I'm reading from verse 1. Jeremiah 33, I'm reading from verse 1. Jeremiah chapter 33, I'm reading from verse 1. Everyone watching on Apostolic TV, invite friends and families. God bless you. Everyone physically here, make sure you receive something for being present. Let the blessing start with you.
Amen.
Jeremiah 33 verse 1 says, moreover, the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah the second time. The word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah the second time while he was yet shut up in the court of the prison, saying, verse 2, thus says the Lord, the maker thereof, the Lord that formed thee, to establish it, and the Lord is his name. Verse 3, call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Father, bless the reading of the word, and let this word put on flesh in our lives and our heart and situations, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I bring you a message titled, when last did you call? When last did you call? Tonight's message is titled, when last? When was the last time you called? When last did you call? The Bible tells us about Jeremiah being imprisoned, and God called on Jeremiah twice. The word of the Lord came to him twice. You know, listen. There is a part of scripture that says, once has the Lord spoken, and twice have I heard, that all powers belongs to God. Meaning when God wants to speak to us or reach out to us, he speaks once. But in the case of Jeremiah, and in the case of us calling on him, God had to speak twice to tell us to call on him. Meaning God is letting us know the importance of making sure we call on him. When people are faced with any situation that seems to have imprisoned them, is it financial, material, career, health issues, spiritual matters, the first thing or the first person they call matters the most. Whoever you call determines how tall you stand.
Hey.
Whoever you call on in the day of trouble, whatever you call on in the day of adversity, whoever you call on when things are not working, determines how tall you stand. Your call determines your height. Mm. Your call determines your height. The Bible says, once has the Lord spoken, twice have I heard. God does not speak twice. But yet, in Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 1, the Bible says the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah twice. And in verse 3 of Jeremiah 33, and the Lord told him, call on me. Meaning God repeated himself twice so that Jeremiah will know the importance of calling. Who do you call on when things are tough? Who do you call on when the going gets tough? Who do you call on when... Listen... Many people are too used to calling on the arms of flesh when the arms of flesh will always fail you. When last did you call on God? Some have called their pastors more than they've called God. Let me bust a bubble and break a religious perspective here and bring a divine narrative into play here. God did not call pastors to train members to call on them. God raised pastors to teach members to call on him, not to call on them.
Yes, sir.
No man is your mediator between your situation and divinity solution. Child of God, there is only one mediator, and that mediator is Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
There is only one middleman, and that middleman is Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one cometh unto the Father but by me. Child of God, I am yet to tell someone, as you call on God tonight, he will answer you.
Amen.
As you call on God tonight, he will answer you.
Amen.
No matter what the situation may be, no matter what the pain may be, I say God will answer you.
Amen.
God will answer you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Listen up. Now hear me. The Bible says that God blessed humanity with a gift. And this gift is called the fivefold ministry. He gave us teachers of the word of God. And teachers work with what? Insight. He then blessed us with pastors. And pastors work with oversight. He blessed us with evangelists. And evangelists work with hindsight. He blessed us with prophets. And prophets work with foresight. He blessed us with apostles. And apostles work with long sight. Why? When you bring all of these sights, both the insight, the foresight, the oversight, the hindsight, and the long sight into one, it brings edification to the church. Not glorification of the man.
Mm.
But we have pastors who are preaching messages, turning them into mini gods and deities in church, where men see their pastor more than they see Jesus. They call men Papa, but they call Jesus PA.
Hey.
They call men Papa, but they call Jesus PA. Child of God, Jesus is the way, is the truth, is the life. No man can be too anointed than Christ.
Yes, sir.
I don't know who I'm talking to yet.
Speaking,
I don't care how they papalize their title. You can never be too anointed in Christ. I will be highly exalted and given a name above every other name. Given a title above every other title. That the mention of the name of Jesus. Powers in the heavens, on the earth,
yes,
and on the
sir.
The power. I want to pray tonight.
Pray, sir.
As you engage this revelational narrative, you will enter your destiny.
Amen.
As you engage this revelational narrative, your life changes tonight.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
When last did you call? Listen up. When last did you call? What number did you call the last time you were in trouble? There is a number to call when you want to engage Jesus. You called him. Well, you called on God today and he answered you. You have a testimony. Don't worry, it's Sunday, you share it. Jehovah's telephone number is J-E-S-U-S. Jehovah's telephone number.
Yes, sir.
His email address. Jehovah's Instagram. Jehovah's Facebook. Jehovah's YouTube channel is J-E-S-U-S. For the Bible says in Acts of Apostles chapter 2 verse 17 and in Joel chapter 2, it says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Who is the Lord? Who is the Lord? Who is the Lord? Who is the Lord?
Yes.
So to reach out to God, to get access to God's mind for you, to get answers to answers for you, to get access to solution,
yes, sir,
you must dial Jehovah's number.
Hey.
And it is called J-E-S-U-S.
Yes, sir.
As you call upon that name,
Father,
you shall receive answers.
Amen.
As you call upon that name, you shall receive answers.
Amen.
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 I want you to jump and shout, Jesus.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise
the
Lord.
Please be seated. There is only one mediator between God and man. It's Jesus. One mediator. God is not Lord. God is not Lord. God is not Lord. God is greater than the Lord.
Hey.
Because he made the Lord.
Yes, sir.
I'm losing you. God is not Lord. I have said many times that Jesus has nothing to give you and I. Jesus cannot give you and I anything.
Mm.
That is why Jesus said, I have to go and prepare you a place in someone's house called his father.
Mm.
My father's house. In there are many mansions. And for you to get there, into my father's house, you must come through me. Jesus is the pass into God's heart.
Hey, hey.
Jesus is the pass into God's agenda for your life. Jesus is the pass into the God's solution for your situation. Child of God, stop calling on your father and your mother. For the Bible says, I was young, now I'm old. I have never seen the righteous forsaking or his seed bread.
Yes, sir.
God never forsake his home. I don't know how forsaken you feel tonight. I'm here to tell you, the next time you feel that way, it's time to change the number you call.
Yes, sir.
Stop calling pastor.
Hey.
Stop calling prophet.
Hey.
Stop calling apostle.
Yes, sir.
Stop calling your father. Stop calling your mother.
Yes, sir.
Stop calling Mr. Doctor.
Yes, sir.
Stop calling your lawyer.
Yes, sir.
Stop calling solicitor.
Yes,
it's
sir.
Time to call J-E-S-U-S.
Yes. Yes.
I want somebody to shout Jesus.
Jesus.
When last did you call? When last did you call? Malabalagadash. There is only one mediator. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 5. For there is one God and one mediator between God and man. The mediator, Christ Jesus. The man, Christ Jesus. A pastor's duty is to narrow down your intimacy with Christ. Is to push you to build your own intimacy with Jesus. The moment some pastors are not in church, people can no longer pray anymore.
Mm.
Pastors have turned to praying contractors. Prophets have turned to seeing contractors. Apostles have turned to decreeing contractors. Teachers they've turned to manipulative contractors. People bound in a place of obscurity and nonentity and immaturity when it comes to their walk with the Lord.
Yes, sir.
A pastor's duty is to edify you to be great in God.
Huh.
When last did you call on God? When last did you call? When last did you call? Oh, things are hard. Oh, no. When last did you call? And who did you call? When? Abba. Am I communicating here?
Yes, sir.
Listen up. One mediator. For God is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. I am not the way to God. The same way you need to pass, it's the same way I need to pass to get to God. We all pass through the same route. I said something on Apostolic TV during the week, and I repeat it again. No man is special than you.
Yes, sir.
The love of God for you and I is the same measure.
Yes, sir.
What differentiates us is the level of grace we've chosen to press into. Grace has been poured out. Apostle Paul says, the grace of God be multiplied unto you.
Yes, sir.
The same measure that has been multiplied to you, has been multiplied to me, has been multiplied to him, has been multiplied to you, and has been multiplied to you online. But the difference is, many refuse to press into grace. When you press into grace, a new layer is revealed.
Yes, sir.
A new layer is uncovered.
Yes, sir.
When you take time to press into grace, you then stand out from the crowd. You then run your race like an ace. Child of God, there is only one mediator.
Yes, sir.
One mediator, and is Jesus.
Yes. Kadosh.
Jesus is the elevator to Jehovah's penthouse. Jesus is the elevator to Jehovah's penthouse. A penthouse is the flat at the top, the apartment at the top of a skyscraper. And you need security pass to get there. Jesus is that mediator. Is that elevator. When people are challenged, I've noticed that the first person that comes to mind, let me call prophet. Let me call apostle.
Yes, sir.
Let me call bishop. Let me call papa. What about calling Jesus?
Yes, sir.
I am not saying calling your pastor is wrong. It's our duty. We are shepherds. But understand that a pastor without the backing of Jehovah through Jesus has nothing to offer you.
Yes, sir.
When last did you call? If I check your phone, your last telephone call. If I check your telephone now, when last did you call on Jesus? When last did you call? When last? And how do you call? How do you call? In the place of prayer. In the place of prayer. What does it mean to call? Please be seated. What does it mean to call? Am I wasting your time tonight?
Not at all, sir. Not at all, sir. Started well, sir.
What does it mean to call? To call means a cry made as a summon or to attract someone's attention. The reason why Christ has not located you is because you've not called out. A call means a cry made as a summon. A cry made as a summon to attract someone's attention. To attract Christ's attention, to summon Jesus into your situation, you need to cry. A call is a cry made as a summon. What is a call? I like this one. The next definition is very interesting. It says, to speak in a loud, distinct voice as to be heard at a distance. No matter how deep in the ground of financial debt you found yourself, when you cry to God with a distinct shout, it can still reach you.
Yes, sir.
There is no valley too deep for Christ's hand to reach.
Yes, sir.
There is no mountain too high for Jehovah to reach.
Yes, sir.
There is no problem too complicated for God not to have the wisdom to deliver.
Yes, sir.
Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
There is no pain so too much for Jehovah Rapha not to have a medicine to heal you. There is no law made by man that cannot be written off or pleaded by the great counselor.
Yes, sir.
The Bible said it shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Prince of Peace, the yes, Mighty sir. God, Emmanuel, God with us. Listen, child of God, there is something about Jesus that carries the solution of man. I prophesy the next time you call on Jesus, answers shall locate you.
Amen.
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 Lift your hands and say, Father.
Father.
Hear my cry.
Hear my cry.
Please be seated. When last did you call? When last did you call? When last did you call? I said a call can be defined as to speak in a loud. That is why the egg. See, if you are praying and you are, Father, you know, I've got to compose myself. I've got to be cool in prayers. You will stay cold in that coolness. There is no man that changed their story in Bible history,
yes, sir,
without a call. And the call came with a loud shout. Jabez cried. Jacob wrestled. Daniel tarried. Jesus wept.
Yes, sir.
Come on. And you fold your hands and you're cool. You will stay cold. Show me the Bible. Zacchaeus climbed a tree, Sycamore tree. Luke 19. The blind man, Luke 18, verse 35 to 43, shouted, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy upon me. A loud, distinct call, and the attention of Christ was magneted towards him. When last did you call? When last did you call? You might be under the sound of my voice and saying, I have called so much. I've been calling, man of God, you don't understand. Don't get weary of good doing. Don't get weary of good doing.
Yes, sir.
For in due season you will surely reap if you faint not. For the effectual fervent prayer of the righteous avails much. The effectual fervent shout and call of the righteous man availeth much. You might have been waiting for your breakthrough for the past 8 years and 5 years and 5 months or 2 weeks. I prophesy tonight, as you call on Christ one more time, answers shall locate you.
Amen.
Answers shall flow your way.
Amen.
Solution shall find you.
Amen.
Answers shall find you.
Amen.
Solution shall find you.
Amen.
Lift your hands, shall power.
Power.
Please do this. Are you understanding me yet?
Yes, sir.
When last did you call? When last did you call? When last did you shout to Christ with a loud, distinct voice? Or are you calling on God like everybody else? Now, when you look at, when a word is defined, the way I read definitions of words is by distinct words in that definition. Distinct words used in the definition. Now, look at what this definition says. It says, a call, to call means to speak in a loud, distinct voice so as to be heard at a distance. Tell me the most powerful word in that definition. What's the most powerful word in that definition I just gave? Eh? What? No, that's not it. Distinct. Distinct. See, listen. If we take out the word distinct from that definition, I will give it the definition without the word distinct. Now, hear this. To speak in a loud voice as to be heard at a distance. Do you know that? Everybody here can speak in a loud voice and with a loud voice. And I, if all of you are calling me at the same time, I might not necessarily know who called me amongst the crowd. But when you shout distinctively, it means you called on me differently from the crowd. The blind man in Luke chapter 18, verse 35 to 43.
Yes, sir.
The way he called on Jesus was different. How? He called on Jesus, mentioning not just his name, but number two, he mentioned his roots. And then he cried for mercy.
Yes, sir.
Others just shouted, Jesus of Nazareth. But he said, Jesus, one, son of David too, have mercy upon me. He shouts this, differentiated his voice from the crowd. Listen, you must not just shout to God or make a call to God, but your call must be distinctive from the crowd.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is why Jesus stopped. When Jesus heard the man in Luke chapter 18, verse 41, verse 42, and verse 43, when Jesus heard the man, Jesus stopped and he said, "What shall I do for you?" Listen, when you catch the attention of Christ, solution is delivered immediately. Not tomorrow, not next week, not next month. I prophesy everything that has been delayed in your life, as you call on God distinctively, answers shall be delivered.
Amen.
As you call on God distinctively, answers shall be delivered.
Amen.
As you call on God distinctively, answers shall be provided.
Amen.
If you believe it, I want you to run at least 1 meter shouting, "I receive my answers.
I 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 receive answers.
I receive answers.
In the name of Jesus."
Amen.
Please be seated.
Hot lunch. A distinct shout. Don't just shout. What makes your shout from her distinct? What makes your shout from him different? That is why the Bible says only the violent. The man had violence in his shout. There is a way you call on Jesus. Jesus have no choice than to find you.
Yes, sir.
I won't look at Jacob. Jacob called, he fought, he wrestled, and the angel of the Lord said, "The day is about to break. Let me go." He says, "I will not let you go unless."
Bless me.
Apart from distinct voice when calling, you must be precise with what you want when calling.
Mm.
If you are generic with your request, you won't get a specific answer. Generic approach cannot produce specific solution. Generic approach cannot produce specific solution. You come to church like everybody else. You then come with a specific mindset that this service is meant for me. I don't care who is there or who is absent.
Yes, sir.
Listen, it doesn't matter who is present when I want to receive.
Yes, sir.
What matters is that I am present and Jesus is present with my presence.
Hey!
I don't think you heard me.
Cardos.
I am present and Jesus is present with my presence.
Yes, sir. Ledo.
I am present and Jesus is present
with my presence.
Can I prophesy?
Prophesy.
Someone is living here with answers.
Amen.
Someone is living here with solutions.
Amen.
Someone is living here with their presence.
Amen.
I prophesy that whatever the Lord has assigned his angels to do through this
prophesy,
service,
sir.
As long as you are under the sound of my voice,
yes, sir.
You are living here with solutions.
Amen.
You are living here with angelic ministry.
Amen.
If you believe it, lift your voice and shout, "Glory!
Glory!
Hallelujah!"
Praise
Please
the Lord.
Be seated. Habalagadash. When last did you call? I want to give you 10 seconds to ask yourself. The last time you called, how did you call? Was your call distinct? Some people are good with service, meaning corporate prayers, but no intimate prayer. Corporate prayer life does not bring intimate answers. Corporate prayer life does not produce intimate revelation. To birth revelation that comes through intimacy does not happen during corporate prayers. If you only fast and pray when pastor calls for church 3 days fasting and prayer, you cannot get intimate revelation. Corporate prayer does not produce intimate revelation. What makes men stand from men is what they are empowered with called knowledge. What makes Bill Gates greater than others is the knowledge he possesses. May God give you the passion for intimacy.
Amen.
I don't think you heard me. the passion to be intimate with Christ, receive it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The passion to build intimacy with the Lord, receive it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen. I receive
the passion to build intimacy with Jesus, receive it now in the name of Jesus.
Amen. I receive.
Corporate gathering does not produce intimate harvest. You can be in church for corporate gathering but never receive any intimate harvest. The harvest you gain with intimacy or in the place of intimacy with the Holy Ghost is revelation, vision, revelation, vision, revelation, vision. Once a man catch a revelation and is empowered by vision, great destination is his possession.
How much?
When you are empowered by revelation, guided by vision, a great destination becomes your possession.
Mm.
Do I repeat that one more time?
Please, sir.
When you are empowered by revelation, guided by vision, a great destination becomes your possession. That is straight from Jehovah's kitchen. When your life is empowered by revelation, guided by vision, a great destination becomes a man's possession.
Yes, sir.
To be a leader is not by age, it's by the revelation, information, and knowledge you are loaded with.
Come on, sir.
When divinity has partnered with you to give you information that humanity don't already possess, you become a great entity over them, and men become non-entity when you appear. Listen, you become a principal over principalities. You become a principal over your mates.
Yes, sir.
It's not by age. Make people drive you Rolls Royce. They don't have 10 heads than you.
Hey.
Don't wait till you are 50, 100 before you drive Rolls Royce. Because my Rolls Royce is coming before the end of this month. I believe it.
Amen.
See, nobody said amen for me, but I've
amen,
said it.
Amen, amen. We receive, sir.
It's amen. Through the... Am I communicating here?
Yes, sir.
Listen, I want to prophesy.
Prophesy, please, sir.
The revelation that will empower your life, the vision that will guide your life to a great destination, I prophesy it becomes your possession.
Amen.
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 I want you to turn around shouting, my time has come.
My time has come. Pardosh.
It becomes my possession.
It becomes my possession.
Please be seated. Quickly so we can pray. Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
When your life is powered by revelation, stop powering your life by gossip. Gossip will make everything that come out of your lips a lie. Gossip will make your life unfruitful. Gossip makes men become mediocres. When men gossip, they are lower than women.
Hey, my father.
Men start gossiping, they end up lower than women.
Hey, he shocked, sir. He shocked me, sir.
When men start gossiping about men, even women will stand above them.
Hey.
When a man is gossiping about another man's success, brother, it's because you are failing.
Nice.
What you need is revelation.
Yes, sir.
Bill Gates, don't gossip about Richard Branson, because they are making their money. They are too busy making money. They are too busy succeeding.
Yes, sir.
They are too busy promoting.
Yes, sir.
They are too busy prospering.
Yes, sir.
Can I pray for someone here?
Pray, sir.
The revelation that will empower your life.
In the name of
the
Jesus.
The vision that will guide your life.
Hey.
To a great destination. Let it be your possession.
Amen.
It becomes 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 your possession.
Amen.
Lift your legs and fire.
Fire.
I forgot that it is Wednesday service. I did not know it's not a crusade.
Continue, sir. Continue,
it's
sir.
Wednesday service. I want to try. You know, Wednesday, there is Wednesday style of preaching. You preach, you put the mic down, and you are talking, and you know God said.
We are not normal at all, sir. Not here, sir.
Come on, shop, say, fire! Okay, don't explode, don't destroy the amplifier. On the
Dash.
Please be seated. God bless you. Quickly, write this down. Calling on God. What happens when you call on God? Or why should I call on God? Why should I call? You call on God to make known his name. You call to make known the name. Whenever you shout Jesus, his name is known. Sometimes the Lord will purposely put you in a situation so you can call on him. Sometimes the Lord will put you in a position. You are there saying, Lord, give me solution, just so that you can mention his name. To make known his name, you call on God. Bible backing. The Bible says in Psalm 105 verse 1, oh, give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds. Make known his deeds among the people. You call on God for his name to have fame. It's called on God. The same as 1 Chronicles chapter 16 verse 8. It says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, call on his name, make known his deeds among the people. You call on God to be saved. Acts 2:17. You call on God to be saved. And whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Call on God to be what? To be saved. Am I communicating here tonight?
Yes, sir.
Number three, you call on God to be rescued from trouble. If you look at, I think it's Psalm 50 verse 15. Can we have it up? Psalm 50 verse 15. You call on God to be rescued from trouble. Psalm 50, verse 15. And call upon me in the day of trouble, I will deliver thee, and thou shalt glorify me. When you call on God in trouble, he comes to you on the double.
Hey. Hey.
When you call on God in the days of trouble, God shows up on the double. But when you call on man on the day of trouble, man leave you with double trouble.
Yes, sir.
Hey, listen to me.
Yes, sir.
Have you not noticed that when the going gets good, you have many friends. But when the going gets tough, you are standing alone.
That's right.
The Bible says riches has many fathers, but poverty is an orphan. Proverbs, it says riches has many fathers, but poverty stands alone. Nobody associates with a man's pain, but they want to celebrate and be part of his gain. Are you understanding me, Joseph?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. You start wearing Gucci suits.
Amen.
Louis Vuitton suits. Whether the devil likes it or...
Oh, yes.
Say yes. The people you should keep in your life are the people that were down in the pit with you. Because not everybody understands the place of the pit. The pit is called Prince in Training. Pa- pastor in training, prophet in training, prime minister in training, president in training, prosperity in training, promotion in training. Are you understanding me?
Yes,
preservation,
sir,
in training. Everything you want to be in life, it is cooked in the pit. It is cooked. That is why every pot is deep. Every pot used to cook soup is deep. The deeper the pot, the more capacity of soup it can handle.
That's right, sir.
So when God puts you in a deep, deep pit, he wants your life to carry so much juice that will feed generations to come.
Yes, sir.
But not everybody will understand your pit. Some people start pitying you, they laugh at you. After laughing at you, they mock you. But they don't know that there is a God who has promised us that he will prepare a table.
Before.
A table.
Hey.
A table.
Hey.
A table.
Yes, sir.
Before me.
Yeah.
In the presence of my mockers.
Yes, sir.
In the presence of those that wrote me off. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 60 verse 15. Even though that thou hast been hated and forsaken, that no man went through thee, I will make you an eternal excellency, a joy of many generations.
Hey.
Can I pray for someone?
Pray, sir.
Wherever they mock you, God will celebrate you.
Amen.
Wherever you have been mocked, God shall celebrate you.
Amen.
Whenever you have been mocked, God shall celebrate you.
Amen.
Whenever you have been downcasted, God shall lift you up.
Amen.
Whenever you've been the rejected stone, I prophesy.
Prophesy.
The title of chieftaincy, receive it.
I receive.
You become the chief stone of the corner.
Amen.
Lift your neck, shall glory.
Glory.
Understanding me?
Yes, sir.
Psalm 50 verse 15. Call upon me in the day of trouble, and I will deliver you, and thou shalt glorify me. Stop calling people in the day of trouble. Call God. Let me tell you the problem. Please listen to this. If you've not heard anything at all, listen to this. The problem with calling people in the day of trouble is that you will narrow your chances of receiving from God. Calling people in the day of trouble will close your eye to the right person and path that God wants to use to prosper you.
Mm.
Because your hope will suddenly be on the call you have made to the person, not on God that can gather men to give you solution.
Yes, sir.
Are you understanding me yet?
Yes, sir.
Stop calling on that man. That man has nothing to offer you beyond his pocket. But there is a pocket that is bottomless.
Hey.
There is a pocket that is limitless. There is a pocket that cannot be phantomed by the economics and the account grades of this world.
Yes, sir.
It's called the bottomless pocket of Jehovah.
Yes, sir.
Can I pray for someone?
Pray, sir.
The access into Jehovah's pocket. Receive it now.
I receive.
I just heard something revelational. The Lord said the access into his pocket that will rocket you into greater.
Hey.
Is opening that access and giving someone that access. If you are the one, I want you to jump and shout, I receive it.
I receive it. Hey,
Kadabash. Please be seated. You're calling men, they're treating you anyhow, and you're still calling them. Any man that try to brag with me, I turn him to rags. The only man that has the bragging right over my destiny is Jehovah.
Mm.
I don't think you're hearing me. The only person that has the bragging right of your life is Jehovah.
Yes, sir.
No man can make you. Even though the man is a president or a prime or crime minister, they cannot make you. Because if God is against you, no man can be for you. If God is against you, no solution can find you. But hear this. When men are against you and God is for you, hey, nothing can stand in the way. If God be for me,
hey,
who then can be against me?
Yes, sir.
The Bible says nothing. For in all these things, through all these things, I and you and I, we are more than a conqueror.
Yes, sir.
I see someone entering victory tonight.
Amen.
The next time you call on Jehovah, I see answers locating you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please be seated. Number 4. Why do we call on God? I believe it's number 4. Yes? You call on God because he's worthy of praise. Even through your pain, call on him because he still deserves the praise. The Bible says in 2 Samuel chapter 22 verse 4, I call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised, and I am saved from my enemies. This was King David's pain and cry in the day of misery and pain. I will call on the Lord. It's a choice to call on God when you are in pain. Do you see? Can you still praise through the pain? Or you murmur and grumble through the pain? I will call on God. I will. He made a choice. A choice decision to call. I will call. Listen. Your confession of faith, when it is good, when things are good, is fake. Let me repeat that. Your confession of faith in God through the good times is always fake, because it hasn't been tested, so it cannot be trusted. But when your confession of faith is coming from the wilderness, David said, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. But if you check, he was in the wilderness, he was alone, he was in want, he was in lack, he was in shame, he was abandoned, he was forsaken, he was betrayed, he has no one to turn to. But he still said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Yes, sir.
I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. No. What the man of God was trying to say, that he was in the bush sleeping on grass. But instead of glorifying the grass and the pain, he turned it to a bed. He said, God has placed me in green, on green mattress called green pastures. You see the way the man of God turned grass to bed. Green pastures. A pasture. Listen, a pasture is where animals feed from.
That's right, sir.
Oh, I'm losing you here. A pasture is where cattle go and feed. He was sleeping where cattle were feeding. He was degraded. A man of God was degraded to sleeping where cattle, where animals, cow and goats were feeding from. But instead of glorifying the position of shame, he said, oh, you make me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil.
Yes, sir.
For thou art with me. Thy rod.
Hey. Listen,
rod does not comfort. When I flog your bum bum with a rod, your anus will catch fire.
Kadosh.
Listen to me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Can you talk to God when God is flogging you?
Hey.
Can you appreciate him when he's flogging you?
Hey.
Can you say yes, sir, when he's flogging you?
Yes, sir.
Can you still say I am here when he's flogging you?
Yes, sir.
You have not eaten breakfast, no lunch, no dinner. Can you say, Jesus, it is me and you, me?
Hey.
Listen, I want you to get to a place with your walk with God, that when the rod and the staff is beating your back, beating your anus, beating your life, you will still say, they comfort me.
Yes, sir.
They comfort me. Because why? There is no process with God that doesn't land you in a place of profit. There is no process you go through with God that doesn't land you in a place of access. Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Listen, that was a prophetic statement, because his enemies wanted to kill him. He said, so Lord, you know I am still standing by you, so you must prepare a table. Listen, when you are chased by the bitterness of life, you are surrounded by the battery of life, prophesy what you want to see. But once you cloud your head with negativity, you will never pronounce positivity. Positive confession stems from negative thoughts. Positive confession stems from positive thoughts. As a man thinketh, so he is. With the heart, man believes. But with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. Your mouth saves you. Your heart aligns you with what will save you. You believe, it aligns you. Your mouth now confess that deliverance into reality. Before we pray tonight, child of God, when last did you call? A call means a distinct shout to catch the attention, no matter how far, of someone. A distinct shout. When last did you call? Or you just pray? Oh, it's Friday prayer meeting. Ila kuku katu katu kataka ila kata mberegelegede. Your tongue is always on fire when you are amongst people, but you are ice water when you are alone with the Spirit. Oh,
Hadash.
You are on fire in church. Your speaking in tongues is like a shooting AK-47 when you are with people, but when you are alone, you are like ice water.
Jesus.
You are colder than the North Pole. You are colder than the North Pole. You've never gotten on your knees to pray. I have said many times, I will repeat it one more time. A man that spends time on his knees before God will spend his life on his feet above men.
Yes, sir.
A man that spends time on his feet before God will spend his life on his... A man that spends time on his knees before God will spend his life on his feet above men. If you are still being dominated by men, it's because you've not placed your feet before the Lord. You can't kneel before God and kneel before men. You cannot call on the name of the Lord and a man put you to shame. I have never seen it. I was young. Now I am old. I have never seen the righteous forsaken. Even though it tarries, God still carries what you need. I don't think you're hearing me. Even though the problem it tarries, God still carries what you need. Your tarrying problem cannot outcarry God's ability to carry your solution.
Hey,
your tarrying situations cannot weaken God's ability to put you in the right stead and position. When last did you call? When last did you call? The Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 18 verse 24, Elijah addressed the prophets of Baal and he says, then you call on the name of your God and I will call on the name of the Lord. And the God who answers by fire, he is God. And all the people said, that is a good idea. You want a different answer, call on a different God. You want a different answer, call on a different God. You want a different answer. See, there are people that serve God, but there is a difference between a capital letter G God and a small letter G God. There are some people that call on God, God don't know them. There are some pastors that call on God, God don't know them. Elisha prophesied, hear me. He prophesied there was famine and hardship, hunger, because why? The enemies of the people of God were encamped around them, and none could go out and none could come in. And Elisha prophesied that by this time of life tomorrow, a loaf of bread shall be sold for less than a shekel. Now hear this. The Bible says, and the Lord on whom the king's hand leaned on said, can this thing be? Even if the window of heaven is open, it cannot happen.
Hey.
Elisha said, you will see it, but you won't partake. But listen, that is all pastors preach. What I focus on is the Bible says, 3 verses later, it says, and God answered the prayer of the man of God. Meaning, Elisha could have said that and God don't answer. Many people have prophesied about St. Vincent. God did not move. I spoke about St. Vincent. Everywhere scattered. You can serve God, but my own is capital letter G, and yours is not capital.
Hey.
When you serve a capital letter G God, you see a capital letter G power.
Yes, sir.
You see capital letter G evidence. You see capital letter G movement. I prophesy any deity, any satanic entity,
yes, sir,
any God, any power that is tormenting, oppressing, captivating and keeping you bound, your life and glory, I call on the God of all gods.
Hey.
I call on the kings of all kings. I call on the Lord of all lords. And I prophesy in the name of Jesus, you are free.
Amen.
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 Lift your hand, shout, I am free.
I am free. I am free indeed. Yeah.